Hey guys, welcome back, and today I am bringing to you look number 2 in my bridal series. As you probably guys know, I am getting married in about a month's time on April 7th. So I have been experimenting with several bridal looks, and this is look number 2. And I think I'm liking this purple halo look. I might actually do this for the wedding. I don't know. I keep changing my mind. So anyways, if you want to see how I created this sort of glowy kind of like purple toned look, then please keep on watching. So I'm gonna start off with my silicone primer from The Ordinary, and I'm just putting that in places where I've got large pores, because you know, creators, and spreading that all over my face with my fingers, so it gives it like that smooth out skin. And then I'm gonna do this technique that I learned from Goss makeup artist, which is to put my translucent powder all over my face before I even put on my foundation. And I'm just letting that stay on there, because if I have any fallout from the eyeshadow that I'm going to use, then this is probably going to be good to catch them, and then it doesn't stick on my face. All right, I'm going to go in with my Smashbox primer water, which I'll be honest with you, I don't really think it does anything. Although when you put it on your skin, it makes it a little bit tacky. So I suppose that makes the foundation work better, but I've only started using it recently, so I don't really have an opinion on it. This is my Milani eyeshadow primer, which I am going to use because I always need a primer on my super duper oily lids. There you go, just spreading that out with my fingers. Now I'm going to go in with my Lorac Pro Contour Palette, and I'm using that yellow shade as a base for my eyeshadow, just over that primer that I've put on. Just all over there so that it will blend easily. Moving on with a light contour, I'm taking that all over the crease. And this is just with a delium brush. I'm going with a dark contour because I noticed that the light contour really didn't do much for my crease, or because I don't actually have a crease. I'm repeating the process on the other eye, starting out with the light one in the inner half and then the dark contour in the outer half, and then just blending them together. There you go. Enough for the blending. Now I'm going into that white matte and using that as my highlight for my brow bone, and also sort of meshing that crease color and the brow bone color together. And I'm using a clean brush for that. Now I'm gonna go in with my Makeup Forever, and I don't know what I'm looking for here, but that's my Makeup Forever 15 Artist Shadow Palette, and that's I922 or Iridescent 922. Oh, I was looking for this teeny tiny brush and realized eventually that it wasn't really helping, because honestly, it was going to take me forever to put in that purple shade if I kept on using that little, sort of a lip brush there. Yeah. And then also here I realized that it was going out of focus. So there you go. I keep trying with that little brush, but you'll see that eventually I will give up and I am actually going to change into a much bigger brush. I went in with I916 or Iridescent 916 in the center to create that halo effect, and you'll see that there. It almost looks white, but it's actually a really pale lilac, which I thought would work well with that purple. I'm adding a little bit of that purple back because I kind of lost it in this transition. There you go. It's focusing on my hand. I don't know why. It annoyed me a little bit, as you can see. So there you go. I realized that it was taking forever for me to apply that purple with that teeny tiny lip brush. So I went in with a Real Techniques shadow brush. And just really repeating the process that I did in that other eye with the purple, the I922 on either sides of the eye, and then the I916 at the center. That is a really pigmented eyeshadow. So much so that it is making the purple ones disappear. So I need to always come back and add a little bit more of those because it just washes it away. And then I'm just going in with a clean brush. The same brush that I used earlier for that contour colors to blend that purple in. Now I'm gonna take from my Makeup Forever eyeshadow palette 2, that really dark purple metallic or ME930, and I'm just placing that in the outer corners, and that's gonna create a little bit of definition. And while it's metallic, it really goes well with these iridescent shades here. There you go. Just building that into that outer corner. Beautiful, isn't it? And I had to adjust the lighting because I don't think you actually see it. This is a Lancome waterproof eyeliner that I'm using to tight line my lash line. And you can see how vibrant those shades are. I'm really loving this look right now. Then I'm gonna take my MAC Conceal and Correct palette, mixing the NW30 and the Peach Corrector, and the Yellow Corrector, sorry, and putting that underneath my eyes to brighten that area. And here I am noticing that that powder that I put in the beginning is actually being removed by that, so it doesn't really stay. But look at how flawless that under eye skin is. I'm using my OXX cushion foundation that actually has IT Cosmetics CC cream in it. And I'm just using the same sponge to put that all over my face. And it gives me that sheer coverage. But I like it because at least I still can see my skin and not some really like fake ass plastic looking skin. There you go. I've got a zit on that, on the bridge of my nose. So you can see there's a little bit of a bump there. Yeah. And I can see that it's sitting on my pores on my nose. So I had to really just give it a little go. Now I'm adjusting the lighting by opening some of the blinds. There you go. Keep scratching my shoulder. Why? Why? And I'm going back with that translucent powder to set that concealer and that foundation, or the IT Cosmetics CC cream. Flawless! There you go. Now I'm gonna go in with my, what are these? Oh, my, this is the black primer mascara from Estee Lauder. So I'm gonna put that, and then I'm gonna layer the Blink tubing mascara on top of it. I'm just really placing that on there so that the lashes separate. I don't have very many lashes, so this is a struggle for me. Then I'm gonna use my Daiso eyelashes for that. I'm going in with my Anastasia Beverly Hills brow pomade in dark brown, and I'm just filling in my brows like they were Sharpie. Fill that in, fill that in. as you do. And then I'm going to brush through it with the spoolie side of it. Bam. Then I'll repeat the process on the other eyebrow, because you can't really be going out with only one brow. So there. Fill that in, shape it. It's a little bit crooked. That left eyebrow is always so naughty that it doesn't really want to listen to me. No matter how much I try to fix that, it just has a mind of its own. So once again, brush through with the spoolie. Remove the excess products. There you go. The right one is always perfect. The left one is always extra. There you go. And I'm going to go in with my Essence Make Me Brow, which has fibers, just to, one, set them in place, and two, add a little bit of fiber on them so that it actually looks like I've got brow hairs instead of just sharpie my eyebrows on there. There you go. Boom. And now I'm going to go back to that Morocco contour palette, going in with a medium shade and a Delium brush. I am going to use that to contour my face. I'm just really following my hairline to my lip, the edge of my lips. I'm going to squeeze that and use the same shade for my nose to contour that area. And then we go in with, what am I going doing here? Oh, I'm going to take the lightest shade from my Viseart blush palette, the lightest purple shade, and apply that on my cheeks with a fan brush, just like so. And it gives it like sort of like a pinkish glow. Then I'm going back to that Lorac and using that shimmery shade. I'm trying to blend them together because then I kind of look like there's something really powdery on my face if I don't. And it sort of appears lilac-y. Now I'm going to spritz my face with the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray so that the powder look is diffused. Then I'm going to go in with, what am I doing here now? Oh, it's my NARS Audacious Lipstick in Vanessa, which is my all-time favorite nude shade. Like, it just makes my lips look so much better. There it is. There you go. Done. And then I'm going to go in back to that Makeup Forever ME930 with a small smudge brush. And I'm going to go back to my eye look and place that at the lower lash line so that it goes together with the upper lash line. There you go. And then I'm going to take a pencil brush and I'm going to go into that ME512 and use that as a highlight in the inner corner. Gorgeous, isn't it? And that is the finished look. And that's it. Now I know it's a little bit like the lighting is a little bit weird, but I'm using natural light, so I'm sorry if it like keeps coming in and out. I'm trying to adjust the camera as I go, but yeah, that's what it is. But that is the finished look, a little bit glowy with a little hint of pinkish purple here and there. Simple and understated, as you would want it to be when you are a bride. I mean, that's what I want. I'd like to look like me when I walk down the aisle. Anyways, thank you very much for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Bye!